Let's do this. Let's talk about hair loss. So, as you know, as I make these two or three videos a day, certain themes rise to the surface. Things that generate from the comments, and there's the theme for the week. And one of those themes these past couple weeks is basically talking about things, would you be willing to do this if it meant you wouldn't lose your hair? That's been, and it all started when people started asking me more about my vegan diet. That, you know, I've been a vegan for 4 years, vegetarian for five, no pork or shellfish for what, almost nine. So, you know, there's a theory going around that maybe my vegan lifestyle has slowed down my hair loss because my hairline hasn't changed since age 31. I showed pictures to prove that, and that's also when I became a vegan, around that time, 31, 32. So, and then I had somebody else who said that he has a brother, and his brother is losing all his hair, but yet he's kept all his hair, and the guy that's kept all his hair is a vegan. So, you know, I was like, well, would you become a vegan if it meant you get to keep your hair? And of course, you can look at me and see I'm not lacking protein, and I'm happy, and all is great. So that was one extreme, you know, situation to put you in. Would you become a vegan for the rest of your life if it meant you get to keep your hair for the rest of your life? Now, I'm not saying that being a vegan means you get to keep your hair, but I'm saying if. There's theory to believe that it could be possible. So, would you? That was the first thing we talked about. And then another extreme that's showed up on the radar last week again is this whole no-fat thing, which I'm not, you know, I'm not one of those people that's all about that. But at the same time, there's reason to believe that there could be science behind this whole release of, you know, the DHT and all that stuff. There's reason to believe. But then at the same time, I mentioned, and Robert agreed with me, that, well, what about Catholic priests? They all seem to be bald. So, you know, and then somebody brought up, well, what about Buddhist monks? You know, and I spent two summers in Bangkok, Thailand. And Buddhism is a huge part of their culture. And everywhere you go, you can't go into the street without seeing men of all ages, whether they're 19 or whether they're 70, and you'll see them in their orange robes with their shaved heads. Of course, you know, I say shaved, a lot of times it'd grown back a couple days, so it was more like a number one or number two. But, you know, and I admit, I mean, as many monks as I saw plenty of them that were balding, you know. Norwood 4, Norwood 5. I was on a train with one. It was an overnight train. And, of course, they don't wear shoes. And, like, he stepped in some mud. And, like, he was, like, there was, like, monk footprints on the train. But, I mean, so, you know, if there was ever a study group for no-fap, wouldn't it be Catholic priests and monks? But there is reason to believe that could possibly have an effect. But even then, there's my next question. Okay, forget about being a vegan. Would you be no fat for the rest of your life if it meant you get to keep your hair? Okay. Let's take it even further. While we're talking about extreme ways to save your hair, that there's some theories that would indicate that this... please know, I'm not saying these things will keep you from losing your hair. I'm saying there's theories behind it. There's been testimonials behind it saying that it worked for them. And even me. I mean, I might be a candidate to tell you being a vegan has stopped my hair loss. Maybe. I don't know. I showed you the pictures in other videos. Okay, now here's the most extreme one. And this is crazy, but I'm just saying it for the sake of, to what extreme would you go to save your hair? So right here in this very spot yesterday, I was talking about transvestites, which now, and thank you for teaching me, because I didn't realize there was a difference between transvestites and transsexuals. So what I was actually meaning to say was transsexuals. Basically, here's what I'm saying. You're born as a male, you grow up, you're a man, and then you become a woman. You know, you go all the way transsexual. So you get the surgery, you start taking the hormones, and more than one person said, well, actually, a lot of times their hair loss does stop because they stop taking the testosterone and all the masculine hormones, and they're now taking feminine hormones. And so therefore, because hair loss is a masculine trait, they're not losing their hair, they're keeping their hair. Okay? So obviously, Now I'm asking you, okay, forget about no fat, forget about vegan. Would you become a woman if it meant getting to keep your hair? Now, obviously, no one's going to say yes, okay? But I'm telling a narrative here to prove a point, okay? And that is, hair loss is undeniably a predictable, let me say that where there's light, hair loss is an undeniable, predictable, masculine quality. Let me say that out loud again, one more time so we get it. Hair loss is a predictable, masculine trait, quality, okay? So look at these extremes I mentioned. I mentioned going vegan, which most people think that, oh, I'm a man, I gotta have protein, I gotta have beef and sausage, bacon, yeah! Of course, I'm the exception to the rule because you can tell that I'm very masculine and confident, yet I have not eaten animal products in years. But still, that's the mentality that most people have. Real men eat meat, okay? So it's an assign with masculinity, okay? Would you give up that part of your masculinity if it meant saving your hair, okay? No fat, okay? And I'm not going to draw on the details here, but there's obviously masculinity involved with no fat. I mean, even if it simply, if you took it to the very extreme and said, I'll become celibate in every way for the rest of my life if it means I won't lose my hair. See how crazy that's starting to sound? Then take it to the final extreme. Well, if I became a woman and I took those, I don't know, I'm in public, hopefully. I care so much about saving my hair, I'll just take different hormones, I'll have the surgery, and then because I have the hormones though, that'll save my hair. See, and what I'm wanting to demonstrate in this video is how laughable it is that we would go through such extremes leading up to those things just to save our hair. Losing your hair is something that is expected to happen to most men. So it's funny because you end up playing this game in your head. You think, well, what extreme would I go to save my hair? Would I become a vegan? Would I do no fat? Would I become a transsexual? Now again, I'm obviously giving very obvious extremes, but I am proving a point. And here's my point, in case I need to spell it out. Aren't you just facing a losing battle? Aren't you really trading in your masculinity in order to try to save your hair if you were doing these things? The only exception is, I would say, being a vegan, and not because I am one, but just because my life's actually better and I'm healthier, and all the health problems I used to have, I don't have anymore. So I'm not doing it for hair loss. It may be a side effect, but I'm not doing it for that reason. But obviously, none of you are going to become a woman, and most of you are not going to be no fap, especially if not for the rest of your life, in order to save your hair. Hair's not worth it. Okay? There you go. Hair's not worth it.